Technically speaking, Bitcoin is currently facing a very tough time. We do see that Bitcoin appears to be forming some kind of basing pattern near the 9600 area. So, is the picture bullish or bearish? Also, what could happen to Bitcoin if a recession occurs in the near term? Well, today we're going to dive into this. Also, if you'd enjoy the content, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. This is iFinance, so let's get into it. So, first of all, the question is, should you sell based on how the chart looks? Well, I suppose that if you're a trader, then merely looking at the chart and ignoring everything else could make sense. Still, remember that short-term price fluctuations have very little influence on Bitcoin's actual fundamentals. After all, as we all know, price targets can change very quickly with one single big green candle that breaks the current bearish triangle structure. Also, have in mind that Bitcoin hasn't broken down just yet. Yes, it is indeed trading on a bearish macro pattern today. However, these patterns never play out 100% of the time. In fact, many times these patterns scare away people before they break down, which causes the price to soar and invalidates the technical analysis. So remember that at the time of this video, there is still no bearish confirmation. In the meantime, Bitcoin continues to improve every day. Every day that passes, more wealth flows into Bitcoin. More people talk about it on the news. The network's hashing power increases, and additional layer solutions are being developed as well. So I do think that over the long term, we should see higher prices for Bitcoin. Also, the fact that Bitcoin's scarcity is increasing every day is a bullish macro trend for us. As of today, we're approximately only 9 months away from the Bitcoin halving. As most of you probably know, whenever this has happened before in Bitcoin's history, the price has gone up substantially over the coming months. So I would say it is very likely that we will see something similar in Bitcoin in the relative near term. Have in mind that most valuation models for Bitcoin seem to suggest that today's Bitcoin price is actually reasonable, despite what most bearish analysts would have you to believe. In fact, the stock-to-flow ratio model for Bitcoin indicates that we should actually be trading lower at $8,300, around that level. So, in reality, Bitcoin's current price is in line with what we should be expecting to see if we think it will eventually go to 1 million. So, really, it is all going as expected. This is why you shouldn't forget that if we look underneath, there are no fundamental bearish signals for Bitcoin, only short-term fears. This is why, in my view, the recent bearishness is probably due to emotions. After all, those who went all in at the top perhaps feel a bit scared by now. A 40% decline is probably causing pain for some hodlers. But overall, I think that we're currently seeing the fear of new investors rather than long-term hodlers. This is why I believe that the recent bearish triangle that we see playing out is unfortunately due to fear of these new investors and not necessarily that we're going to break down and Bitcoin is going to disappear or something like that. And unfortunately, sometimes these types of situations can be resolved with one big flush once this pattern breaks down. Under such a scenario, those who chased at the top would capitulate and liquidate all their holdings in despair at around 8,000, I suppose. The truth is that washouts like that do occur and often precede massive rallies to new all-time highs. Look, I'm not saying that this is the way it will play out, but have in mind that these patterns sometimes do play out like that. And in any case, I do think that even if we break down to 8,000, then we would continue our next leg higher after that, because after all, we would be in line with the stock to flow model. So please be aware that a potential breakdown to 8,000 is entirely possible. But as I said, more importantly, if this happens, remember that it would still be in line with Bitcoin's stock to flow model. So overall, I think we are still very healthy and looking good so far. Also, I think that technically speaking, we should see some type of resolution to this pattern we're seeing by the end of September at the latest. I do want to point out that there are a couple of new dynamics at play. As most of you must have heard by now, the yield curve was recently inverted very briefly. Whenever this has happened in the past, it has signaled an incoming recession within months. Typically, whenever this happens, the Federal Reserve responds with massive rate cuts and quantitative easing. Now, this can get a little bit technical, but it really isn't necessary to go into the details. All you have to know is that what this does is create a couple of dynamics for Bitcoin in particular. First, it will probably weaken the dollar. Thus, Bitcoin should rally in response to that. This would be congruent with what we saw after the recent Fed meeting, where they decided to cut rates by 0.25%. When they did this, Bitcoin and gold rallied. These are so-called safe havens. So far, this relationship seems to be holding up. However, at the same time, there's a second dynamic that happens whenever the Fed decides to cut the rates all the way down to zero. After all, this typically signals the beginning of a recession, and we really don't know what could happen to the price of Bitcoin during a recession. However, Bitcoin could possibly behave somewhat like gold did during the last financial crisis. For context, in 2007, the price of gold was at around $800. Then in 2008, and this was during the height of the recession, gold increased slightly to $870. Finally, when the recession was about to end, or actually ended in 2009, the price of gold reached a new high of $1,100. So this is roughly a 30% increase in the price of gold during the Great Recession of 2007 to 2009. Generally speaking, the price of Bitcoin has 10 times more volatility than gold. So this is what I'm thinking. If a recession comes and it is similar to the last one, we should see a 300% increase in the price of Bitcoin, which would translate to a $40,000 price target. However, as I said, this is only an estimate of how Bitcoin could behave during a recession like the one we had from 2007 to 2009. After all, so far this year, Bitcoin has been acting somewhat like gold, but in a very much more volatile way. Thus, a recession could possibly be positive for Bitcoin. However, the truth is that if you look at it the other way around, it could be that people get scared away. It could be that people try to liquidate their Bitcoins to raise some cash during a recession. So we really don't know. But I'm leaning towards thinking that it would behave somewhat like gold behaved during the recession. But anyways, lastly, I just want to caution you against panic selling if Bitcoin sells off. There are many technical analysts out there that always sound 100% certain. You know who they are. However, their game is basically to sound bearish whenever the price of Bitcoin goes down and to become bullish whenever the price of Bitcoin heads higher. This is why you should ignore the noise and simply focus on the fundamentals and hold for the long term. But anyway, that's it for today, folks. Please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. It really helps the channel a lot. Also, leave a comment and tell me what you think could happen to Bitcoin during a recession. I'm very interested in this subject, and I would like to have a discussion if you like. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.